the future challenges. Water use efficiency, which is the focal theme of this conference, is also a crucial challenge in regard to the utilization of our limited water resources which are available to us. Agriculture consumes about 78% of the total water use, but has a very low level of efficiency, that is an average of 38% as compared to 50 to 65% in developed countries. Nearly ignored aspect of recycling of the used water requires to be accorded top priority. Industries and municipalities need to be mandated to adopt the water recycling practices. Industry and construction sector need to adopt water harvesting practices religiously. We are trying to address these challenges through National Water Mission, which is one of the 8 missions under the National Action Plan for Climate Change launched by Honorable Prime Minister in 2008. The objective of National Water Mission is conservation of water, minimizing wastage, and ensuring its more equitable distribution both across and within states through integrated water resources development and management. One of the important goals of this mission is to increase the water use efficiency by 20%. Adoption of better management practices and proper regulation, budgeting and auditing of water users are very important for enhancing the water use efficiency. There is an ample scope for improvement in water use efficiency in agriculture and the industry. We are encouraging integrated management of water resources by conserving water, minimizing wastage, and equitable distribution. We are making our concerted efforts by keeping various stakeholders involved in the process, exploring and implementing the use of micro-irrigation, promotion of water neutrals and water-positive technologies, recycling of water, are important aspects being pursued by the National Water Mission. We are also focusing on the local and traditional wisdom in water conservation and water use efficiency. Central Water Commission under the Ministry of Water Resources have already 138 major and 73 medium irrigation projects for baseline study of water use efficiency. Similar baseline study will be carried out for water supply of domestic and industrial uses. The Ministry has also constituted an interministerial committee to increase water use efficiency addressing each sector. Number of parallel efforts to amalgamate all the sectors in this endeavor are on way, like dialogue with the industries, real estate developers for promoting water use efficiency and taking up water use efficiency CSR activities, interaction with various ministries, organizations, especially municipal boards and panchayats. So my ministry is also proposing for constitution of National Bureau of Water Use Efficiency, which will work with the state government to develop appropriate benchmark and facilitate intervention necessary to achieve these benchmarks. The Bureau will also have the overall responsibility of improving water use efficiency across various sectors in the country. The water use efficiencies need to be improved through continuous water balance and water accounting studies. It is our endeavor not to leave any stone unturned, be it policy making, regulation, or stakeholders' consultation to promote water use efficiency and converting it into a people's movement. I would like to congratulate TERI, particularly the Water Resources Division, for organizing such an important and timely event, and also the Ministry of Urban Development, the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, and the World Bank's Water and Sanitation Program for their support to this cause. I express my sincere thanks to the organizer for inviting me in the conference and giving me an opportunity to share my views in the benign presence of our Honorable President, a great planner, renowned economist, as well as a great administrator who possesses an enormous capacity to motivate the polity. His address in this conference will be a great guiding factor for all of us, we all believe. I hope that the discussion generated by the distinguished speakers and audience over the next 3 days will be of great use in the successful tackling of the water sector challenges. I wish all success of India Water Forum. Thank you very much.
Shri Harish Rawat, Minister for Water Resources, Dr. Shoshi Tharoor, Minister of State for Human Resource Development, R.K. Pachauri, Director General, Energy and Resource Institute, Sri Prakash, Distinguished Fellow of TERI, Excellencies, Distinguished Participants, Ladies and Gentlemen. It's indeed a privilege for me to be present amidst you this morning and to participate in the inaugural session of the Second India Water Forum. At the outset, I would like to congratulate the Energy and Resource Institute, TERI, and the other supporting partners, Ministries of Urban Development and Drinking Water and Sanitation in the Government of India, and the Water and Sanitation Program of the World Bank for organizing a program of true global relevance. I am happy to be given the opportunity to address this distinguished gathering of water sector experts, researchers, academicians, policymakers, and the students. Once, Leonard da Vinci made an observation, and I quote, "Water is the driver of nature," unquote. In India, water evokes reverence in people. It is given the status of the incarnation of God, Varuna, who is worshipped as the god of all forms of water element. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, India is home to 17% of the world population. However, it possesses only 4% of the renewable water resources. Population expansion, rapid urbanization, and developmental needs have exerted tremendous pressures on India's water availability. From 1,816 cubic meter in 2001, the per capita availability of water has reduced to 1,545 in 2011. It has been estimated that it will further reduce 1,140 cubic meters by 2050. Water security, which already is a formidable challenge, is going to aggravate in the future. As we grapple with the diminishing water resources and escalating water demand, water use efficiency holds great promise. In today's context, the saying, "water saved is water generated," is truer than ever. This conference, by focusing on water use efficiency, will help to bring the important issue to the forefront of the policy discourses. National Water Policy 2012 recognizes the needs to improve the efficiency in the use of water resources. Improvement of water use efficiency requires innovative tools of promotion and incentives for efficient water utilization. At the same time, it calls for dealing with inefficient water consumption through disincentives and stricter regulation. In the past, focus was laid primarily on augmenting the quantity of the water available without giving proper attention to the manner in which the water will be used or managed. A paradigm shift from water resource development to integrated water resource management is now necessary. For that, the existing institutions involved in the service delivery have to be restructured and strengthened. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, The threat of climate change is real and contemporary. By altering river flows, decreasing groundwater recharge, intensifying floods and droughts, and allowing saltwater intrusion into the coastal aquifer, climate change can severely affect water resources. This challenge has to be met by efficient water management as part of the National Action Plan on Climate Changes. The National Water Mission was launched in India in 2011 with the objectives of water conservation, minimization of wastage, and equitable distribution. One of the most important goals of the National Water Mission is to increase water use efficiency by 20%. Historically, agriculture has been the biggest consumer of water in India. But due to unprecedented and rapid urbanization, urban water demand has compelled the shift of the water resources from rural to urban consumers, creating an intersectoral rivalry. With the sources of water remaining unchanged, this intersectoral competition over allocation of water is likely to rise in future. Addressing this situation calls for efficient allocation of water between various sectors. Our country's agriculture is a big demand center for water. Water management in this sector is therefore crucial for overall sustainability of our water resources. The 3R strategy of reduce, recycle, and reuse has to find application in our farmlands. Our irrigation system has to encourage judicious use of water. Our efforts of recycling and reuse of wastewater have to be doubled. India has to also learn from countries like Israel, where effective water policies and technological advances have led to water use efficiency in agriculture. The decreasing groundwater level has to be contained by resorting to improved water use technology and better management of aquifers. Rainwater harvesting has to be popularized by dovetailing existing rural development schemes like Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. Our initiatives at integrated watershed development have to aim at increasing the soil moisture, reducing the sediment tilt, and improving water productivity. Usable water is a scarce commodity. The pricing mechanism has to act as an incentive for saving and disincentive for wastage. Role of Water Users Association has to be strengthened by giving both adequate powers for collection of water charges and management of the water distribution system. The provision of safe drinking water has become a serious development initiative around the world. There is a significant portion of humanity which remains denied of access to this basic necessity. The reach of the poor to safe drinking water has to be enhanced by developing mid-market technologies that can deliver affordable water treatment devices. Microfinance institutions have to be engaged to acquire devices and encourage shared access to safe drinking water. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, current legal framework pertaining to water in India is non-uniform and inadequate to deal with the complex water situation. A broad overarching national legal framework of general principles on water could pave the way for essential legislation on water governance in the country. concerted efforts is also required to make the water sector policies and regulations clear, coordinated and comprehensive. Only then can India hope to mitigate the impact of looming water crisis. I am aware of the good work being carried out by TERI in the water sector. With the expertise that TERI commands in areas like integrated water resources management, climate change, and domestic and industrial water management, I am happy that it has chosen to take the lead in organizing this event. I am most certain that this three-day conference will witness comprehensive and dispassionate deliberations on various aspects of the water use efficiency, which will help to develop a consensual understanding on water use management. I hope that this convention will showcase advanced knowledge and successful technological developed in different countries and promote international knowledge exchanges for addressing challenges related to water security. I wish the organizers very best in successfully conducting this conference. I also wish them all success in their endeavors. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.